Well, hello there, motherfuckers, and welcome to your Raw Preview, the first Raw Preview of 2015, of the first Raw of 2015, motherfuckers. And the Authority is back. Oh, fuck! They're back again. They weren't even gone for just a little bit more than a month. They're already back. They go through a whole spiel. Dolph Ziggler is going to be the man of 2015. Sting comes back, all this shit, to finally get Triple H and Stephanie off TV, and they're back again. Well, there you go. That's your 2015 present right there. More Triple H. WWE's New Year's resolution's already been set. Let's do the same fucking shit. Let's change nothing about the product. Let's just keep recycling old, used fucking bullshit that ain't getting us no ratings and no new fucking fans. Just the same old fucking bullshit. It's the same fucking cycle. You know, the thing is, like, I still watch it, and you might ask why, but the thing is, I actually get it. I understand. WWE's gonna keep doing the same fucking shit goddamn over and over again. Most of you people think, you know, you're under this type of impression that this is something new that WWE's doing. They've done this for fucking over a decade now. You know, many people act like this is something new and recent. They were doing this shit long before the PG era. Long before mid-2008 when the PG era was introduced. This fucking shit has been going on for fucking forever, repeating the same fucking shit. They've been repeating shit over and over again. That's what they're going to keep on doing until the end of motherfucking time. And what do they got advertised for tonight besides the Authority but an ambulance match between Ambrose and Bray Wyatt? Now, to me, the TLC match, now that kind of seems like, well, at least to me, like that should have been the end of it right there. Like a TLC match, that's usually like the end of a fucking feud. Doesn't an ambulance match seem kind of like a step back? Like, it doesn't seem as, you know, like, threatening as TLC, like, fucking hitting people with chairs and ladders. It doesn't seem as bad as putting somebody in the back of an ambulance. You know, this really doesn't seem like the end of a feud. It kind of seems like something kind of in the middle. It doesn't seem as bad. You know, this is kind of like having a Hell in a Cell match and then having a steel cage match right after that. You know, you kind of think to yourself, well, one of these things is actually, you know, less bad than the former. So I really don't fucking see the point to that. You know, they're taking a step back. You know, when you up the stakes, you know, that's what it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be more dangerous. That's why you're upping the fucking stakes. They're actually lowering the fucking stakes. And this is a bit perplexing to say the least. Like, once again, I have to ask, who the fuck is booking this shit? It makes no fucking sense when it comes to wrestling logic. Your typical wrestling logic would dictate that the ambulance match should come before the TLC match. You can fucking rack your brain thinking about this shit. It's just professional wrestling, so it's probably not fucking worth it, but it's really fucking just annoying after a while that they just can't even get the simple things right anymore. Well, anyway, also Randy Orton is advertised. Now, I was hearing reports that Orton got to the arena late last week, that he was supposed to save Edge, you know, and Christian, but I don't really know what the fucking true story is there. I really haven't seen all that much information about this, but, you know, rumors were saying that Orton was supposed to be there last week. Could the motherfucker get to his job on time? You know, what the fuck is this? What, you know, he's allowed to show up whenever he is? He has a scheduled appearance, and he doesn't fucking show up? They should fucking dock his pay or something. Holy fuck, I mean, come on. Deduct this from his fucking salary, from his fucking check. I mean, goddamn. The man's not even there for fucking work. He can't show up for fucking 5 minutes to save another wrestler. You know, it's not like a fucking match or anything. Goddamn. I mean, he can't even fucking show up for goddamn fucking work. And Lesnar ain't going to be there again. We're championless once more. You know, we're not going to fucking see Lesnar probably the night before the Rumble or maybe the Rumble itself. So there you go again. You know, this Raw, I'm not really getting a whole bunch of excitement radiating off of this thing. So, you know, I don't know. I'm expecting a lousy Raw, but I might be fucking surprised. Fuck knows, my fuckers. Who the fuck knows anymore? You know, what a way to start off 2015. You can't even be excited. You know, they used to book a lot of major shit for the first Raw of the new year. You know, okay, so maybe Cena and Kevin Federline probably wasn't the best thing one year. But okay, you know, at least it was like a major thing that was, you know, being advertised like crazy. This is like, you know, it's a new year. You know, we should do something special. You know, just go there to writers eating their fucking Cheetos, slouching in their chairs, and just fucking picking lint out of their motherfucking belly buttons. For God fucking sakes, get it together! It's a new year! They should fucking change shit. You know, we thought shit was gonna change last year with the supposed reality era, and that proved to be bullshit. The reality era was, you know, was the reality that WWE still fucking sucks! That's what the reality was. Fucking bullshit.